Okay, in annual equivalent method, we have two subtypes of problems. One is type one. In type one, we have used this formula C is equals to P minus of L, which is multiplied by CRF. CRF means capital recovery factor plus L into I plus OMR cost. And this formula is applicable only when the problem is made with the OMR cost and salvage value. Okay, so this formula C is equals to P minus of L into L, which is multiplied by CRF, capital recovery factor, plus L into I plus OMR cost. This formula is applicable only when the formula is made with salvage value and OMR cost. Okay, already in the last class, means on Saturday, we have solved two problems on the type one. Okay, two problems on type one under annual equivalent method. Okay, in today's class, we are discussing type two problems. Okay, type two problems under annual equivalent method. Okay, in annual equivalent method, we have two subtypes of problems. One is by using formula, calculate the annual equivalent cost by using the formula, direct formula. And here we have one more type, that is type two problems. Okay. So in this type of problem, we are not using formula. Okay. So please, all of you look at the slide, type two problems under annual equivalent cost, annual equivalent method. In this annual equivalent method, our aim is to find the annual equivalent cost. Okay. Our aim is to find the annual equivalent cost for the various alternatives. Okay. Annual equivalent cost for the various alternatives. Okay. Annual equivalent cost means constant amount of benefit or constant amount of investment every year for some period. Okay, constant or uniform amount of investment or uniform amount of benefit every year for some period. Okay, that is the annual equivalent cost. Most commonly, that annual equivalent cost is indicated by the letter A. Okay, A indicates annual equivalent cost. Okay, so take a first problem under type 2. Okay, under okay annual equivalent method. See, all of you please look at this slide. Okay, two types of our converters. Okay, two types of our converters, alpha and beta, are under the consideration for a particular company. Has made at I is equal to 10% determine the annual equivalent cost of two systems from following details. Okay. Class moves on. Okay. Okay. So I'm repeating one more time here. Okay. See, two types of our converters, alpha and beta, are under the consideration for a particular company has made at I is equals to 10%. Determine the annual equivalent cost of two systems from following details. Okay, here is given one table. Okay, so it includes alpha values and beta values for the alternatives. Okay, here alpha and beta are the alternatives. Okay, in this problems, alpha and beta are the two alternatives. Okay, so he has given purchase price. Okay, alpha means the power converter. Okay, the first alternative, that is power converter, having the purchase price of 10,000 rupees. Okay, and the same alpha is having estimated service life is 5 years for the alpha and salvage annual operating cost. Okay, salvage annual operating cost given is 2,500 rupees. Okay, these are the values for the alternative alpha. Okay, here these are the, so first one, purchase price, it means this is the investment cost. Okay, initial investment, that is 10,000 rupees for the power converter alpha. Okay, and estimated service life of the power converter alpha is equal to 5 years. Okay, and annual operating cost given is 20. And one more value he has given, salvage value. Okay, salvage value is 3,000 rupees for the power converter alpha. Okay, salvage value means resale value. Okay, keep it in mind, salvage value means resale value. This salvage value is the benefit for the person. Okay, always this salvage value is positive. Okay, this salvage value or resale value is the benefit for the person. Okay, and usually this salvage value will be indicated at the end of the service life. Keep it in mind. The salvage value should be come at the end of the service life of the alternative. Okay, and the annual operating cost given is 2,500 rupees. Okay, these are the values under the power converter alpha, and similarly, the values for the power converter beta are 25,000 rupees, that is purchase price. It means initial investment cost for the power converter beta given is 25,000 rupees. And the estimated service life of the power converter beta is equal to 9 years. Okay, 9 years, which is for the power converter beta. And resale value or salvage value for the power converter beta given is 5,000 rupees. Okay, and annual operating cost of the power converter beta given is 1,200 rupees. Okay, these are the some values for the alternative alpha and beta. Okay, and this table is attached to the question. Okay, so by using this table, we have to find in this problem, our aim is to find annual equivalent cost. Okay, annual equivalent cost for the alternative alpha and annual equivalent cost for the alternative beta. And finally, we have to choose the best alternative. Okay. So first find the annual equivalent cost for the alternative alpha and beta. And finally, you need to choose the best alternative among two. Okay. So first consider the alternative as alpha. Okay. Power converter alpha. Consider all the values of alpha for the drawing the CFD cash flow diagram. Okay. Draw the CFD for the alternative or power converter alpha, okay, by using these values. Okay, purchase price for the alpha is 10,000 rupees. So purchase price is nothing but initial investment. Okay, and the service life is 5 years, and the salvage value 3,000 rupees, and annual operating cost, okay, 2,500 rupees. Okay, purchase price, is it investment or benefit? Purchase price, is it investment or benefit? Purchase price. What is this price? Purchase price. Investment or benefit? Are you there? Okay, fine. See, this 10,000 rupees is the investment. Okay, so purchase price, so initial investment, and service life given is 5 years. Salvage value 3,000 rupees. Salvage value means resale value. Okay, this salvage value should become at the end of the service life. Okay, and salvage value is always positive. So this is the benefit for the given person. Okay. And next, annual operating cost. Annual operating cost is the investment every year for given period. Okay, investment 2,500 rupees is the investment every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, so draw this CFD for this alternative alpha. Okay, so in the CFD, I'm showing this, this horizontal axis is representing life of the service life of the alternative alpha. Okay, so the service life given is 5 years, so that's why I have divided this horizontal axis into 5 numbers. Okay, and purchase price is 10,000 rupees. This 10,000 rupees is the initial investment, so I'm showing this vertical line below the horizontal axis at the 0th year, because this 10,000 rupees is the initial investment for the alternative alpha. Hence I am showing this vertical line below the horizontal axis. Okay, and Next is salvage value. Keep it in mind, salvage value always positive. This is the benefit value for the person, and salvage value should be come at end of the life, end of the service life of the alternative. Okay, so hence I am showing this 3000 rupees as salvage value at the end of the service life. It means I am showing this value at the 5th year. Okay, because always salvage value is nothing but resale value. Resale value should be come at end of the service life. End of the service life. So this 3000 rupees is the benefit for the person. So I am showing this vertical line above the horizontal axis at the 5th year. Okay, because the salvage value should be positive and it should take place at the end of the service life. Okay, and one more value we have, that is 2500 rupees. This 2500 rupees is the annual maintenance cost or annual operating cost of the power converter alpha. Okay, so annual operating cost, it means the power converter alpha requires 2500 rupees every year for a period of 5 years. Okay, so power converter alpha requires 2500 rupees every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, so first year the power converter alpha requires 2500 rupees for the maintenance or operating, it means for the repairing purpose. In the second year, third year, fourth year also it is requiring 2500 rupees for the repairing. Even in fifth year also it is requiring 2500 rupees as the repairing cost. Okay, So this is about CFD for the alternative alpha. Okay, one is 10,000 rupees, another one 3,000 rupees is the benefit, 10,000 rupees is the initial investment, and this 2,500 rupees is the constant investment every year for the period of 5 years. Okay, and I am indicating this 2,500 rupees as the A. Okay, A means annual equivalent amount. Okay, and in this problem, our aim is to find the annual equivalent amount for the alternative alpha. Okay, how you find the annual equivalent alpha? So I'm indicating this annual equivalent cost for the alpha as AEC alpha. Okay, all of you please look at the slide AEC alpha. It indicates annual equivalent cost for the power converter alpha. Okay, annual equivalent cost for the alternative alpha, okay, is equal to minus 2500 rupees. Okay, this 2500 rupees is coming below the horizontal axis. It means you have to consider the sign convention here. Okay, this 2500 rupees is coming below the horizontal axis. It means this 2500 rupees is the investment. Hence, I am showing it as negative. Okay, because the in sign convention, the benefits are always positive and investments are negative. Okay, this 2500 rupees is the investment. So minus 2500 rupees. Okay, and don't convert this 2500 rupees to any further value, because already it is the annual equivalent cost. Okay, in this problem, our aim is to find annual equivalent cost. Already this 2500 rupees is the annual equivalent cost. Don't convert this value to further value. Okay, just consider the sign convention. Okay, here I am considering only sign convention minus. Okay, minus 2500 rupees. Already this is in annual equivalent cost. Okay, so don't convert this to further value. And next is 10,000 rupees. This 10,000 rupees is the initial investment. So this is indicated by P. Okay, P means initial investment or single payment at the 0th year. So 10,000 rupees. Okay, we have to convert this 10,000 rupees to further value. Okay, we have to convert this 10,000 rupees to the annual equivalent value. Okay, annual equivalent value. How do you convert this 10,000 rupees to annual equivalent value? By using this formula. I have written one formula here. Okay, take this formula. A is equal to P into bracket 1 I into bracket 1 plus I whole raised to n divided by 1 plus I whole raised to n minus half 1. This formula is applicable to convert this 10,000 rupees to the annual equivalent. Okay, it means here you have to convert P values to the A. Okay, A means annual equivalent cost. Okay, this formula is applicable. A is equal to P into bracket I 1 plus I whole raised to n divided by 1 plus I whole raised to n minus of 1. Okay. So take this formula in the equation. Okay. Minus 10,000 rupees. Okay. And sign convention for this 10,000 rupees is negative. Okay. Because this 10,000 rupees is the investment. Hence, I am showing this 10,000 rupees as negative. Okay. Minus 10,000. So this is the P value into bracket I 1 plus I whole raised to n divided by 1 plus I whole raised to n minus of 1. Okay. In this formula, substitute I as 10%. Okay. In the question only he has given I value as 10% for both the alternatives and substitute n value as 5. Okay. Because for the alpha alternative, the service life given is 5 years. Okay. Substitute all the values in the formula. Okay. And we have one more value in the CFD, that is 3,000 rupees. This 3,000 rupees is the benefit for the person, and sign convention for this is positive. Okay. Plus. Okay. Plus. And this 3,000 rupees is the F value. Okay. F value, single payment F value. You have to convert this F values to the A. Okay. F values to the A. It means future amount of money to the annual equivalent cost. Okay. So how you convert this F to A using this formula? I have written one formula here. A is equal to F into bracket I divided by 1 plus I whole to N minus of 1. Okay. Substitute all the formula, all the values in this formula. Okay. And consider this formula in the equation. Okay. So plus F value is 3,000 rupees into bracket I divided by 1 plus I whole to N minus of 1. And in this formula, substitute I as 10% and N as 5. Okay. So this is the equation for this alternative alpha. Okay. Then substitute all the values in the formulas. Then finally, you will get a value annual equivalent cost for the alternative alpha as minus 4,646.58 rupees. Okay. So after substitution, you are getting annual equivalent cost for the power converter alpha as minus 4,646.58 rupees. Okay. So similarly, calculate the annual equivalent cost for the power converter beta. Okay. So for the beta, the values given are purchase price 25,000, estimated service life 9 years, salvage value given is 5,000 rupees, and annual operating cost given is 1,200 rupees. Okay. By using these values, draw the cash flow diagram. Okay. Draw the cash flow diagram for the alternative beta. Draw the cash flow diagram for the alternative beta using these values. This 25,000 rupees is the initial investment, service life 9 years, and salvage value or resale value at the end of the service life given is equal to 5,000 rupees, and annual operating cost. Operating cost means repairing cost. This is the investment takes place every year for given period, that is equal to 1,200 rupees. Okay. By using these values, draw the CFD. Okay. Draw the CFD. So 25,000 rupees. Okay. Here the horizontal axis is representing service life of the alternative. Okay. In the, for the beta, the service life given is 9 years. That's why I have divided this horizontal axis into 9 numbers. Okay. And the 25,000 rupees is the initial investment purchase price. Okay. 25,000 rupees. This 25,000 rupees is the investment. Initial investment, hence I am showing the vertical line below the horizontal axis at the 0th year. Okay, and consider this 25,000 rupees as P value. P value means investment, initial investment or single payment. Okay, consider this 25,000 rupees as initial investment. And also one more value he has given. Annual operating cost. Okay. Annual operating cost. It means the power converter beta requires 1,200 rupees every year for 9 years. Okay. So this power converter beta requires 1,200 rupees as the repairing cost every year for the period of 9 years. Okay. Hence I am showing all the vertical lines below the horizontal axis. Okay, it means the first year, second year, third year, this power converter beta requires those 1200 rupees as the repairing cost, and also continuation until 9 years. Okay, this power converter beta requires same 1200 rupees. Okay, and consider this 1200 rupees as the annual equivalent cost, annual equivalent amount. Okay, and in the data table we have one more value, salvage value. Salvage value for the alternative beta given is 5000 rupees. Okay, salvage value always at the end of the service life. Okay, and salvage value always positive. Okay, hence I am showing one vertical line above the horizontal axis at the 9th year. Okay, the vertical line above the horizontal axis at the 9th year indicates salvage value or resale value. Okay, that is 5000 rupees. Okay, here I have not written this 5000 rupees. Okay, so this line indicating the line above the horizontal axis at the 9th year indicating 5000 rupees. Okay, this 5000 rupees is the salvage benefit for the person. Okay, by using this CFD we have to find the annual equivalent cost for the alternative beta. Okay, so use the same procedure, okay, as that of alpha. Okay, AEC beta is equal to, AEC means annual equivalent cost for the power converter beta, that is equal to minus 1200 rupees. Okay, here we have one value 1200 rupees. This 1200 rupees is the annual cost. Okay, already this 1200 rupees is the annual cost value. Okay, don't convert this value to further value. Okay, just consider the sign for this. Okay, so this 1200 rupees is the every year investment for the 9 years. So consider this as negative sign convention, minus 1200 rupees. Don't convert this value to further value because this 1200 rupees is already annual equivalent cost. Okay, so next value is 25,000 rupees. This 25,000 rupees is the investment. The sign convention for this is negative. Okay, minus. Okay, and consider this 25,000 rupees as the initial investment. This initial investment is indicated by P. Okay, letter P. Okay, here you have to convert this P to A. Okay, you have to convert this 25,000 rupees to the annual equivalent cost. And which formula is applicable for this? Find A given P. Consider this 25,000 as P, and you have to find the value of A. Okay, so which formula is applicable? Here I have written one formula. The first one is applicable. How to find? You have to find the value of A given P. Okay, the first formula is applicable. A is equal to P into bracket I, which is multiplied by 1 plus I whole to N divided by 1 plus I whole to N minus of 1. Okay, use this formula for converting this 25,000 rupees to the annual equivalent cost. Okay, minus 25,000. This is P. Okay, into bracket. Same formula. Okay. Okay, I, which is multiplied by 1 plus I whole to N divided by 1 plus I whole to N minus of 1. Okay, in this formula, substitute I as 10% and N as 9 years. Okay, service life for the power converter beta is 9 years. Okay, hence, substitute N as 9 years here. Okay, and similarly we have one more value, 5000 rupees at the end of the service life. So this vertical line above the horizontal axis at the 9th year is showing benefit for the person, that is 5000 rupees. Which formula is applicable? And consider this 5000 rupees. Consider this 5000 rupees. See, wait for 1 minute. Okay. Yes. See, consider this 5,000 rupees. Okay, the vertical line above the horizontal axis indicating 5,000 rupees. Vertical line above the horizontal axis at the ninth year is indicating salvage value. It means resale value. So this is the benefit for the person. And consider this value as F. Okay, F. You have to convert this 5,000 rupees. This F values to the A. Okay, F to A. It means given F, find A. Okay, which formula is applicable? Here, look at the slide. I have written one formula in red ink. Okay, A is equal to F into bracket I divided by 1 plus I whole raised to N minus of 1. This formula is applicable to convert the 5,000 rupees to the A. Okay, and this is the F value, salvage value at the end of the service life. 5,000 rupees. So convert this 5,000 rupees to the annual equivalent cost. So consider this formula in the equation. Okay. So plus 5,000 rupees. 5 means 5,000 rupees. It means this is the F value into bracket I divided by 1 plus I whole raised to N minus of 1. Okay. In this formula, substitute I as 10% and N as 5 years. Okay. And substitute all the values in the formula and calculate the annual equivalent cost for the power. Converted beta. Okay, so after simplification, you are getting annual equivalent cost for the power converter beta as -5,172.8 rupees. Okay, so after simplification, you are getting annual equivalent cost for the power converter beta as -5,172.8 rupees. Okay, so here we found totally two values. Okay, annual equivalent cost for the power converter alpha as -4,646.58 rupees, and one more value, annual equivalent cost for the power converter beta as -5,172 rupees. Okay, so what is our aim here in this problem? Our aim is to find the our aim is to choose the best power converter among two. Okay, choose the best power converter among two alternatives. Okay, which one is the best here? Alpha is having the value -4,646 rupees. Another one -5,172 rupees. Okay, so choose the alternative or choose the power converter having the least value. Okay, which power converter is having the least value, alpha or beta? Alpha is having -4,646 and beta is having value -5,172 rupees. Okay, choose the least value. Okay, considering the sign. Okay, so the power converter beta is having the least value compared to alpha. Okay, compared to alpha, hence I am choosing this power converter beta is the best one. Okay, best alternative. Okay, because here you have to choose the power converter having the least annual equivalent cost. Okay, least annual equivalent cost. Here the power converter beta is having the least annual equivalent cost. Okay, hence I am choosing this power converter beta as the best one. Okay, best alternative. So this is the solution for this type 2 problem under annual equivalent method. Okay. Okay, in this type we have one more problem. Okay, on the same method, annual equivalent method under type 2. Okay, already I have written this solution in notes. So just practice by following the same procedure. Okay, what I have solved now. So follow the same procedure for solving the problem too. Okay, so now I have completed this module 4. Okay, we have completed this module 4. So totally we have discussed eight types of problems here. Okay, see, the first type, problems on simple interest, then problems on compound interest, cash flow diagram, problems on the single payment and uniform series. Okay, and next, problems on the uniform gradient series. Next, methods of comparison. Okay, under this we have solved 2 to 3 problems on the present worth method, and also 2 types of problems under the annual equivalent method. Totally we have solved 8 types of problems under module 4. Okay, from next class I'm going to start the next module, that is 5th one, last module. If you have any doubts on this, then please ask it now. And today I will share the notes on the 4th module. And please text your USN number in the chat box and be in line for 1 minute. Okay. Any doubts on today's problem? Annual equivalent method, type 2. Okay, in annual equivalent method, we have 2 types of problems, 2 subtypes, type 1, type 2. Type 1 by using formula. Type 1 directly by using the formula. See, the type 1 directly by using formula, and second one, the same procedure as that of present worth method. Okay, here also you can use the direct formula. Okay, but the problem should be made with OMR cost and salvage value. Okay, here also in this problem also you can use the formula, no problem, you will get the same answer. And from tomorrow, we are going to start the next module, that is 5th one. 5th module, that takes hardly 5 to 6 classes to complete. And 5th module is purely theory, that is related to business management. If you have any doubts on all types of problems, you can ask me. Okay. Now you can leave the class. Thank you.